I'm Seamus Dunhu of Eve University. I recently received a request to explain the racial ships and weapons, so that's what I'm going to do in this episode. Before I begin, I should point out that in Eve Online, the race of birth of your character does not limit what ships or weapons you can use. If you're a Galente character and you want to cross-train into Minmitar, you can do that. If you're a Minmitar character and you want to cross-train into Amarian ships and weapons, you can do that. If you're a Kaldari character and you want to cross-train into everything else, you can do that. Alright? Your race of birth does not constrain what ships and equipment you can use. You just need to inject the necessary skills and train them up. Additionally, many weapons can be fit to many different kinds of ships. Right? It's a wide degree of freedom. It's not complete freedom. You are constrained by the number of slots on the ship, by the kinds of hardpoints on the ship, the size of its drone bay, or even if it has a drone bay. So there are some constraints, but you do have a wide degree of freedom in how you fit your ship. But some ships have bonuses for particular kinds of weapon systems. I'm looking at the market screen. If you don't know where the market is, you can go to the Neocom on the side of your screen and click on the market button. And that will take you to the market window. And let's go to the browse tab and make sure show only available is turned off. So this checkbox down in the lower left corner should be empty. It should look like this. Now let's go to ships, battlecruisers, standard battlecruisers, and you know what? Let me demonstrate it, expanding the list. Click on ships, click on battlecruisers, click on standard battlecruisers. Now, what I'm about to tell you applies to more than just the battlecruisers. I'm just taking battlecruisers as an example because they are very representative of the combat ships for each race. And let me go through these one at a time. So starting with the Amar, the Amar have two Tech 1 battlecruisers, the Harbinger and the Prophecy, and both of them have bonuses for lasers. It could be called lasers, it could be called energy weapons, they both refer to the same thing. Right. So they have bonuses to laser systems. And the Harbinger has 7 turret hardpoints, the Prophecy has 6 turret hardpoints and a launcher hardpoint. Now, lasers. Let's go to ship equipment, turrets and bays, laser turrets. Lasers, there are in two general categories, beam lasers and pulse lasers, and these are further divided into the various sizes. For all turrets, small turrets are intended to be used by frigates and destroyers, medium by cruisers and battlecruisers, large by battleships, extra large by dreadnoughts, and I think Titans. For a given size category, the beam lasers are the long-range lasers. Pulse lasers are the short-range. And if I take the medium-sized lasers as an example, let's take a look at the Heavy Pulse Laser 1. Go to the Attributes tab. It's got a fall-off of 4 kilometers, optimal of 10 kilometers, tracking speed of 81.25 milliradians per second. Compare that with a cruiser-sized beam laser. Let's take the Heavy Beam Laser 1. That is a fall-off of 8 kilometers, an optimal of 20 kilometers, but a tracking speed of only 33 milliradians per second. With any turrets, there is a long-range and a short-range version. So beam lasers long, pulse short, and what they all have in common is that the short-range version has shorter range but better tracking, usually better damage as well. The long-range version of the turrets have worse damage, and worse tracking, but better range. Hence the term long range. Lasers use frequency crystals. So ammunition charges, no, not project. Here we go, frequency crystals. And with the ordinary frequency crystals, these never run out. Really, your capacitor is your ammunition, and the frequency crystals just dictate the amount of damage done by your weapon and the range. So it's your main capacitor that's the ammunition, and since your capacitor can be managed, you don't have to return to a station or someplace to refill your capacitor. You could be out in the field for quite a long period of time and not have to worry about ammunition, as long as your ship doesn't get blown up. Of course, if your ship gets blown up, you're going to have to get a new ship, new weapons, new frequency crystals anyway. All right, but you don't have to worry about being resupplied. You don't have to worry about ammunition supplies. Your regular frequency crystals will last forever. Or at least they will last as long as your ship. The downside, however, is all lasers do only EM and thermal damage. So if you're fighting something that's highly resistant to electromagnetic and thermal damage, you are up the creek without a paddle. All right, so your da effective damage against that target is going to be pretty bad. For example, if you are running missions against the Angel Cartel. So your agent tells you some Angel Cartel pirates are blockading a gate. Go shoot the Angel Cartel pirates. And the Angel Cartel pirates are weak to explosive and kinetic damage, but they have very good EM and thermal resistances. As a laser user, you are in trouble. Oh, besides the fact that you don't have to worry about being resupplied, you don't have to worry about buying ammunition all the time or making ammunition all the time, laser crystals can also be switched instantly. So you tell your laser's guns to stop cycling, and when they stop cycling, you can switch ammunition types. Maybe you'll go for a shorter range frequency crystal that does more damage, and that changes instant once your guns have stopped cycling. And then you can get right back into firing. Any other weapon system, that is any other kind of turret, and the missiles have a 10-second reload delay. Not for you. As a laser user, you can switch your crystals instantly. Let's move on to the Caldari. So we have the Drake and the Ferox for the Caldari battlecruisers. And the Drake is bonused for missiles, and the Ferox is bonused for medium hybrid turrets. Now, the missiles have a bewildering array of names for their launchers and their ammunition. So bewildering that I am going to refer you to one of my other videos, which gives you an introduction on the different kinds of missiles. I won't go into further detail on those here, except to say that for any given size of missile, there are four different kinds of missiles, one for each damage type. All right. So the rockets, for example, you've got Foxfire, which does thermal, Gremlin, which does EM, Phalanx, which does explosive, Thorn, which does kinetic. If you want to look at the cruise missiles, all right, the Cataclysm does thermal, Devastator does explosive, Paradise does EM, the Wrath does kinetic. These are pure damage types. So as a missile user, you can choose what kind of damage you want to do. If you think the target is most susceptible to explosive damage, you load up the explosive missiles. If you think the target is most susceptible to thermal damage, you load up the thermal missiles. Right? So you can choose a pure damage type. The downside, besides the bewildering array of names that will easily confuse a new player, is that missiles require time to reach their target. So it needs time to get there. Am I forgetting anything else about missiles? No, I th think that pretty much covers it. So, oh, the Caldari also use hybrid weapons. That's hybrid turrets. The Caldari and the Galente both use hybrid turrets. And speaking of, let me move on to the Galente. So the Galente have the Brutix and the Myrmidon. Now the Brutix is bonused for medium hybrid turret damage, and the Myrmidon is bonused for drone hit points and damage. Now for hybrid turrets, like for the late energy turrets, the hybrid turrets have short and long range versions for each size range. The blasters are the short range, railguns are the long range. And if we look at the blasters, let's see, let me take a heavy ion blaster. Optimal of 2.5 clicks, fall off of 4 clicks, tracking speed of 110 milliradians per second. If we look at the railguns, let's take the 250 mm railgun 1. That's an optimal of 24 kilometers, fall off of 12 kilometers, tracking speed of 23 milliradians per second. So again, long range version does less damage and has poorer tracking speed. The short range version does more damage and has better tracking speed. And hybrid turrets are limited to kinetic thermal damage. So if you look at the hybrid charges, the hybrid charges all do some amount of kinetic and thermal damage. So if you're using hybrid turrets, that's all you've got available. Thankfully, many different kinds of NPCs are usually susceptible to at least kinetic or thermal. So you're not as much up the creek without a paddle when fighting NPCs. Angel Cartel are susceptible to explosive kinetic. Sancha's Nation in missions, not to be confused with Sancha's Nation in incursions. Sancha's Nation in missions, Blood Raiders are susceptible to EM thermal. Serpentis and Garista are susceptible to kinetic thermal. So against Garistas and Serpentis, hybrid weapons are a good choice. Against anything else, not as effective, but at least one of your two damage types will be partially effective. So that's hybrid weapons. Drones. There are a number of Galente ships that are bonus for drones. In the Tech 1 ships, the ships that have bonuses for drones are the Arbitrator class Samarian cruiser, the Vexer class Galente cruiser, the Mirandon class Galente battlecruiser, and the Dominix class Galente battleship. These Tech 1 ships have bonuses to drone damage. Many ships have a drone bay. So if you look at the Brutix, it's got a drone bay, 50 cubic meters, 50 megabits per second. You look at the Amarian Harbinger, 50 cubic meters, 50 megabits per second. Look at the Prophecy, 25 cubic meters, 25 megabits per second. All right. You look at the Cyclone, 40 cubic meters, 40 megabits per second. So many ships have a drone bay. Not all of them, but many of them. So many ships can use drones, but there aren't all that many ships that are specifically bonused for drone damage. So most ships, the drones are an afterthought. The drones are primarily an anti-frigate tool. Oh, I'm assuming the viewer knows what drones are. I should not make that assumption. So if we go to the drones category, combat drones, and let's go to light scout drones. Drones are basically semi-autonomous flying turrets. You load them into a drone bay while you're in station, and when you go out into space, you'll have a window called a drone control window, and you can select your drones, right-click on them, tell them to launch, and the drones will go flying in space, and you can use hotkeys to tell them to attack your current selected target. And the drones will go flying to that target and orbit it and go pew 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 as they go around the target in circles. Many ships will use light drones at the very least because their onboard weapon, if they're cruisers or bigger, if whoever's using the drones are cruisers or bigger, their onboard weapons are good against other cruisers and bigger. But they have problems with small targets. Frigates are too small. They won't take full damage from cruiser-sized missiles. They're very hard to hit with cruiser-sized guns. Even more so for the battleships, they take very little damage from battleship-sized missiles and are very hard to hit with battleship-sized turrets. So you use the drones to deal with the frigates. On most ships, the drones are something of an afterthought or an anti-frigate measure, or both. But with ships like the Mirrodon, that are bonused for drone damage, most of the damage comes from their drones, and their onboard high slot weapons are the afterthought. Especially true for the Dominix battleship. All right. Most of the damage on a Dominix battleship is coming from the drones, not from the hybrid guns on the Dominix. So there are many different kinds of drones. I'm not going to cover them all. They are pure damage types according to race. Amarian Jones do EM, Galente Thermal, Kaldari Kinetic, and Minmatar Explosive. However, at least for the light, medium, and heavy drones, if you look at the attributes on a drone, There's a number called the damage modifier. For Galente Jones, this is 1.6. For the Amarian Acolyte, this is 1.15. For the Kaldari Hornet, this is 1.45. For the Minmatar Warrior, this is 1.3. Because the Galente drones do more raw damage than the other racial kinds of drones, you typically want to use Galente drones most of the time. In player versus player situations where you're dealing with fast targets, you'll want to use Minmatar drones instead, because the Minmatar drones are the fastest of the drones, and they will be the most likely to catch up the target to catch up to the target that you want them to hit. Whereas Hobgoblins, Hornets, and Acolytes might get outrun, and they'll never catch up. Additionally, if you're running missions and you're going up against the Angel Cartel are very susceptible to explosive damage, not so susceptible to thermal damage, so despite the fact that Galente drones do more raw damage, the Minmatar drones do explosive damage, and that's more important for hitting the Angel Cartel's explosive hull. So, Galente drones, usually, Minmatar drones for PvP, or Angel Cartel. So much about drones. Let's move on to the Minmatar ships and weapons. And they have this for the battlecruisers, they have the Cyclone and the Hurricane, and both of them are bonused for projectile turrets. And the projectile turrets, like any other turrets, they have a long and a short range version. The autocannons are the short range, and the artillery are the long range. If we take a look at the 425mm autocannon 1, that's an optimal of 2 kilometers, fall off of 9.6 kilometers, tracking speed of about 106 milliradians per second. The optimal range is so short on autocannons, generally speaking, that you're typically fighting within fall-off distance. You don't want to try to get within optimal range to use your autocannons. It's very unlikely to happen. You usually settle for fighting within the optimal plus fall-off. So with this thing, 11.6 kilometers before your skills and ship bonuses come into play. Artillery. Let's take the 720mm howitzers as an example. It's got an optimal of 20 kilometers, fall-off of 17.5 kilometers, tracking speed only 22 milliradians per second. Now, where the lasers only do EM thermal, and the hybrids only do kinetic thermal, projectile is all over the place and depends heavily upon the projectile ammunition that you load. And you could go looking at the information on the different kinds of projectile ammunition. Carbonized lead is kinetic explosive, depleted uranium is explosive kinetic thermal, EMP is EM with a tiny bit of explosive and kinetic, fusion is explosive kinetic, phase plasma is thermal kinetic. It's confusing enough that I made my own chart. Right. Oh, by the way, you might want to copy this chart for yourself. Hybrid weapons, the ammunition in terms of damage and range, laser weapons in terms of the damage and range, projectile weapons in terms of their various properties. So these are the damage types of the different projectile ammunitions, as well as the bonuses they apply. EMP, phase plasma, and fusion cut the optimal range in half, but they are the most damaging. Titanium, sabo, and depleted uranium are the mid-range. They don't change the optimal, but they give you a 20% tracking bonus. So they increase your tracking speed by 20%, or at least 20% higher than if you were using EMP, phase plasma, or fusion. Proton, nuclear, and carbonized lead are the least damaging, but they have the best range. They will give you another 60% on your optimal range, and another 5% on your tracking speed. Feel free to copy this chart and put it into your notepad on your Neocom. So that covers the projectile weapons. And that should basically cover the different racial kinds, the different racial ships and weapons. Again, these are just what these vessels are bonused for. You can fit drones to many kinds of ships. You can fit missiles to anything that'll have a missile launcher hardpoint. You can fit turrets to any ship that has turret hardpoints, provided, of course, that it works within the power grid and CPU. Sometimes people come up with rather odd fits, and it makes sense. Notice that the Myrmidon only has bonuses for drone damage and armor repair amount. It doesn't have bonuses for any kinds of guns, but it does have 6 turret hardpoints, so a lot of people will fit projectile weapons to a Myrmidon. Oh, I forgot one last thing. Capacitor. Lasers use a lot of capacitor energy. Hybrids require some capacitor energy, not as much as the lasers do, but they need some capacitor energy. Projectiles and missiles do not need capacitor energy, so you can save that capacitor energy for something else, like armor repair, shield boosters, different other kinds of modules, maybe to run your resistance modules. But yeah, projectiles, missiles, they do not need your main capacitor. So you could be energy neutralized to zero, and your projectiles and missiles will continue firing until your ship explodes. Alright. And with... Oh, what was my previous point? Right. So these are what the ships are bonused for. You don't necessarily have to follow those bonuses. I have heard of rather unusual fits. It's common to fit projectiles to a Myrmidon. I have heard of some people who will fit artillery to an Abaddon-class Amarian battleship. The Abaddon is not bonused for artillery, but some people like fitting artillery to an Abaddon. So you are not constrained to the bonuses offered by the ship. You don't make use of the bonuses if you don't have the right kinds of weapons fit to it, but you are not necessarily limited to them. So I hope this provides a good introductory explanation of the racial ships and weapons. In the meantime, thank you for watching.